to look at the grim sidewalks that stretch under Highway 50 at the south end of Midtown Sacramento, it's hard to understand why anyone, no matter how desperate, would want to call these blocks home. It's always dark. It's dirty. It stinks. And there's an incessant rumble of cars and trucks, punctuated by the occasional blaring of a horn and screeching of brakes. But for Shane, a homeless man I found absent-mindedly drawing on a piece of paper inside his tent on Monday afternoon, the underpass and the nearly 300 people who have lived there with him for months had come to feel familiar. The only reason he agreed to move a few blocks away to a new, city-sanctioned camping site for homeless people, known as a safe ground, is that others from the encampment were going, too. "They told me we could come over here," Shane mumbled, under the protective gaze of two friends. "So here I am. I can't help but feel there is a lesson in here for Los Angeles, where city officials are still getting grief from some of the homeless people who were forced out of their commune-like encampment in Echo Park and dispersed to temporary housing all over the county. As I wrote last week, some of those former park dwellers have found being split up so dispiriting that they're thinking about abandoning their 4- and 5-star hotel rooms, provided under the government-funded program Project Roomkey, and returning to the squalor of streets. Others, fearful of losing track of everyone in the community they had built on the banks of Echo Park Lake, never went to a hotel at all. While their distress is likely to garner little sympathy from housed Angelenos who are rapidly losing patience with mushrooming encampments, it does raise important questions about the effectiveness of LA's strategy on homelessness if people won't take the help that's offered. Which brings me back to Sacramento. Faced with a similar need to clear a massive homeless encampment on short notice, in this case, so Caltrans could start work on widening Highway 50, officials here decided to find a way to keep as many people as possible together. Sacramento City Council member Katie Valenzuela moved quickly to hammer out a deal with Caltrans to use a parking lot alongside Highway 50 for the safe ground. The city then tapped outreach workers to spread the word that all those at the encampment had to do was pack up and move less than a mile down the street. Those who did so would have access to bathrooms, food, services, storage and, most important, could continue to come and go as they please. "We're trying to help people get off the streets, but also remain part of a community, even while they're living outdoors," explained Mayor Daryl Steinberg, who also is co-chair of the state's Homelessness Task Force. "It's really important that we honor that," said Valenzuela, whose background is in community organizing.